finished. You see, when God raised Jesus from the dead, God gave us power over death in every sense and in every way. And if we let it, then that same power would dwell upon the inside of us. And so guess what? I've made the decision that if I lay myself down, then I can trust that God will resurrect me with new life and with new grace each and every day. So guess what, Beulah Baptist Church? I'm getting ready to take my seat. But today and tomorrow and the day after that and the day after that and the day after that, because I believe that God's about to do something new, instead of me seeing it as another daunting task to be met or an unknown to be feared, I'm making the conscious decision that I'm going to trust in God's sovereignty over new. And so I'm believing God for new blessings. I'm believing God for new trials. I'm believing God for new failures. But I'm believing God for new victories. I'm believing God for new opportunities. I'm believing God for increase. I'm believing God for increase. I'm believing God for increase. I'm believing God this morning for new beginnings. I've come to tell you this morning, church, that this is the season for new beginnings in your life. That wherever it is that you're going through in your life, God wants to do something new for you. God is getting ready to heal you. God is getting ready to deliver you. God is getting ready to set you free. God is getting ready to open up some doors. God is getting ready to make some ways out of no way. I dare about 500 folks up in here to just jump up on your feet and find three folks around you and high five them with some Holy Ghost in you and say, get ready, get ready, get ready. Tell them, get ready, get ready, get ready. Because God sent me here to tell you that your process, whether it's been good or bad, your process, whether it's involved more happiness or sadness, your process, whether you've been through the storm and you've been through the rain, your process, whether you've been through a good deal of sickness and pain, God told me to tell you to get ready, because God is getting ready to turn your good into very good. I said, get ready, because God's about to turn your good into very good. God's about to land a stamp of approval over your life, because new beginnings are on the way. What am I telling you this morning, church? I'm trying to tell you that your current situation is not your final destination. That God's about to turn your midnight into day. He's about to make your enemies your footstool. He's about to be your joy in sorrow. God's about to be your hope for tomorrow. He's about to give your problems an expiration date. I tell you, if you believe it, to shout out loud, yes. Now somebody turn to your neighbor. Come on and turn to your neighbor and shake their hand. Shake their hand. Shake their hand. Look them in the face. Look them in the face. And do like Pastor Black says, don't hold it like a dead fish, but hold it with some grip in your hand. Hold it with some authority in your hand. And say, neighbor, I don't know about you, but I refuse to leave this house the same way that I came. I refuse to leave this house with the same spirit. I refuse to leave this house with the same praise. I refuse to leave this house with the same authority. Because new beginnings, I said new beginnings, I said new beginnings are on the way. Now somebody give God some praise. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, and give God some praise. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, and give God some praise. Go ahead and praise Him for your new beginnings. Go ahead and praise Him. for your new breakthrough. Go ahead and praise him for your new healing. Go ahead and praise him for your new deliverance. Go ahead and praise him for the new phase in your life. I dare about 1,000 folks up in here who believe in the power of God, who believe that all sickness is not unto death, who believe that your current situation is not your final destination. I dare you on the count of three to give God some praise in this house. One, two, three, go. Hold up right there. God is in the process of making all things new in your life. And what you need to realize is that because God wants to make all things new and you just made the decision, turn into your neighbor, let him know you're not going to partake in the same authority and in the same praise. If you want something in your life that you've never received before, if you want a new breakthrough, if you want a new blessing, you cannot take this moment for granted. It is imperative that you take advantage of the authority of the Holy Ghost in here right now. And so this time, when the command of the Lord goes forth, this time, when it's time to praise, give him a new praise. With a new authority. To get some new power, to get some new blessings, because we serve a God who's able to do exceedingly abundantly above everything that we could ask or think. And so on a count of three this time, I want somebody in here to lose your mind in the Holy Ghost. I want somebody in here to scream to the top of your lungs. I need somebody in here to dance. I need somebody in here to holler because you got to do something new. On the count of three, one, two, three, go. Go ahead and give him a praise. Go ahead and praise him for your new beginning. Go ahead and praise him because you're walking into your destiny. Go ahead and praise him because you're living in your purpose. Go ahead and praise him. Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him. I don't know about you, but I feel the Holy Ghost in here. I said, I don't know about you, but I feel the Holy Ghost in here. We serve a God who's able to do exceeding abundantly above everything that you could ever ask or think. It's time for you to trust God for this new season of new beginnings in your life. There's a song, it simply goes like this, and choir, help me sing it. It says, God is able to do just what he said that he would do. And he's gonna fulfill every promise to you. So this is what I want to tell you. Don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. Because he's able. Anybody know the song? Go ahead and clap your hands up and say he's able. If you dare to believe it, I dare you to sing it with me and say God is able. God is able to just what he said. If you believe in us, take it up just a little bit higher.
God is able to do just what he said.
Anybody believe that this morning? And he's gonna fulfill every promise. So this is what I want to tell you. Don't give up on God. Don't you give up on God. Don't you give up on God. Because he won't give up on you. Yeah, yeah. I dare you to say it like you mean it. And say, he's able. I dare you to say it one more time like you mean it. And say, he's able. I dare somebody to declare that out of a hard place in your life. Don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. I want you to allow that to instill into your spirit right now, that you don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. You know, one of the worst things we can ever do is give up on God. We can give up on our situations. We can give up in our battles. But we don't need to give up on God, because if God is the source of your strength and the strength of your life, then what do you have? So don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. I dare you to just say that real quick over and over again until it really seeps into your spirit. Don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. Don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. Turn to the person to your left or your right and say, neighbor, don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. Find somebody else random around you who you don't know and say, don't give up on God, because he won't give up on. Now this time I want you to talk to yourself and say, don't give up on God, because he won't give up. This time when you talk to yourself, say, self, don't give up on God, because he won't give up. One more time, say, self, don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. Because he's able. Now somebody give God some praise. Bask in his presence in this moment. Worship him. Honor him. Adore him. Magnify him. Lift up his holy name. And don't you give up on God, because God will never give up on you. God bless you. I love you.